A day in history to remember. Here it is, October 17th, 2003. Good evening, everyone. I'm Joey Popp. Our top story, the 50th anniversary of Joe and Peggy Popp, our beloved parents. It was 50 years ago today, in 1953, when the Pennsylvania transplant married the Jonesville native in Winston-Salem. It was a private ceremony. They are the proud parents of three children and four little ones, grandchildren, in Montreal, Canada. And this is a tape of memories and well wishes from loved ones all over the country and beyond. And we begin this broadcast in one of your favorite places, Montreal, Quebec.
Hi, Grandma, Grandpa, Mom, and Dad. We want to wish you a ready, guys. Happy 50th anniversary. And we love you. Here's Bud the Stale Wagon. And we love you very much. And, you know, 50 years, my gosh, I hope we can make it that long. And if we're anything close to what you two have done, and especially raising our family, and I hope that we can carry on that tradition, because you've taught me a lot, and we try to carry that on. Now, we're laughing here, because this is really taking an effort to get us all in a video camera, and I hope you're enjoying this, but we can't wait to enjoy this day with you, which we should all be together by now. And we'll give you plenty of hugs and kisses and wish you many more years together. So again, from my friend, happy 50th anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Hey, Mom and Dad, congratulations. This is just unbelievable and wonderful. Happy 50th anniversary. It's fantastic the two of you to have been able to share your lives together this long, and I hope for many, many years to come. I know myself and Kim hope, dream, and pray that we can share that many years together and more as we raise our family. I know on behalf of me, baby of the family, it's just, I've had just an unbelievable life growing up, and the foundation that you've laid as parents for a family. It's obvious that with the success that your children have had as they've moved on, and the success the two of you have had together in the business world and as parents raising family. I'm honored and that you're my parents. You're by far the two most wonderful people in the world. As an individual, me growing up, I hope that I've given you a lot of smiles. I know at times you've probably wondered what kind of man I was going to be if and when I grew up. I've been blessed, my family, to be able to give you some grandchildren, which I hope has given you back a lot of love, and I know many a laughs. And again, from behalf of my family, Kim, Hannah, Haley, Preston, and Hudson, and the Big Bunda, we're just so very proud of the two of you. We're happy we're going to get to share this wonderful day with you. We wish you many, many years to come with happiness, and let's just have a joyful, wonderful day today. A lot of laughs, good times, hugs and kisses, tears, and remember this forever. And again, your son, Jimmy Popp, and his family wishes you and congratulates you for your 50th wedding anniversary. I love you so much. God bless the both of you, and let's have a great time today. Are you going to see Grandma and Grandpa next week?
Yeah.
Are you happy?
Yeah.
Are you going to give them a hug and kiss?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know why you're going to see Grandma and Grandpa?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they visited the JT Masks.
to see Gracie and Oscar. Is it Grandma and Grandpa's anniversary?
Yeah.
Are you going to wish them a happy anniversary?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Happy anniversary.
Wish them a happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
And do you know why you're going to see Grandma and Grandpa?
Yes.
Why?
Because they're gonna marry each other again.
Marry each other again. That's right. You wanna say tell them something?
Happy anniversary.
Okay, can you sit still and say it?
Happy anniversary.
And you wanna tell them something else? You wanna tell them to now? Hey, you wanna tell them you love them?
I love you.
Now, do you know why you're going to see Grandma and Grandpa?
Yeah.
Why?
It's going to the wedding.
To their wedding. Now, it's their 50th anniversary. Would you like to say something to them?
Yeah.
What do you want to say?
Happy anniversary.
You want to tell them you love them?
I love you.
Now, standing by in our nation's capital, your beloved daughter, Karen.
Happy 50th anniversary, Mom and Daddy. So happy to be part of the celebration, and also just to tell you how much your children love you very, very much. You know, we grew up in a wonderful family environment because of you all. And I just want to thank you for the life that you've given me. As I've said for many, many years, I know that I've become what I am because of you. And I just want to thank you very much. Happy 50th, and I love you very, very much. Also, Webster wanted to wish his grandma and grandpa a happy anniversary, didn't you, Bud? Do you want to wish grandma and grandpa a happy 50th? Yes, you do. Happy anniversary. And I know that Oscar and Gracie and Chase and Bunda and Simon and Bailey all wish you a happy, happy anniversary. And if our other animals were around, Lassie and Bubba and Wiggy and all the others, I know they would wish you a happy anniversary. Anyhow, happy anniversary from the Popp animals.
Time to come back to the Carolinas, and standing by is your daughter-in-law, my wife, Catherine, with our very good friend, Claudia Rucker.
Joe and Peg, from the Rucker family, we would like to wish you a happy 50th anniversary and many more. And just remember, Peg, the next time you get mad at Joey.
Just wanted to remind you that 10 years ago, almost to the day, Joey and I arrived at your house and announced to you guys that we, too, were going to tie the knot. So if only we're so lucky as to make it another 40 years. Congratulations and all the best. We love you.
A lot has happened in the last decade since you said, I do. To give you an example, it was the first concert 50 years ago today of contemporary Canadian music that was presented in the U.S., and it was performed at Carnegie Hall. The Korean War continued as B-29s flew day and night missions. And back home, it was a wet year. A tropical storm hit Palm Beach County, Florida, causing flooding. Well, it's now time to hear from your brothers and sisters. First off, we have the Bob Popp family standing by in Michigan.
50th anniversary, Joe and Peg.
Hi, Uncle Joe and Aunt Peggy. I just want to wish you a happy 50th anniversary, and you have a golden day. Love you. Bye-bye.
Hi, Aunt Peggy and Uncle Joe. Sure wish I could be with you on your 50th wedding anniversary. Please have a wonderful, wonderful anniversary. Not many people make it as long as you guys did, and that's wonderful. Love you.
Hi, Joe and Peg. Happy 50th wedding anniversary. God bless you. God has been so good to bless you for so many years. Have such a beautiful family. We were also blessed to have the 2.5 years we had down in Winston-Salem with you. So happy we did have those years to be able to bond and grow with you. Love you. Have a very beautiful day. Bye.
Hi, Joe and Peg. Congratulations on your 50th. My, how time flies. Joe went to Catawba College. All of a sudden, Joe graduated from Catawba College. Then enters the scene, Peggy. What a great person and a wonderful lady. Next thing I know, here comes Sugar and Bob down to with Joe on football camp down in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. All of a sudden, Joe and Bobby are coaching together at Wake Forest. What a wonderful 2 years Barb and I and the family had with you down there. Now here it is, time flies, but memories go on, and so does love. We love you very much. Happy 50th.
Congratulations!
We love you.
We love you.
Take care. Have many, many more.
Many, many, many more.
Let's now go to Raleigh, where the Worth McDonald family is waiting to greet you.
Peggy and Joe, this is the McDonald family. This is Father's Day in the year 2003. Frank and I just want to wish you the very best of our 50th anniversary, and thank you for leading the way. You realize that in a couple of years, we're going to also be celebrating our 50th anniversary. And for you younger folks, like the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren, you see what can happen to you in 50 years. But anyway, best wishes for a happy anniversary and best wishes for many more to come.
Hi, Peggy and Joe. We are so happy to be here to help. Send you a message to tell you that we love you and we wish you so much happiness. I know you're very proud of those three children and those grandchildren, and it's going to make this for a happy, happy occasion.
Four grandchildren.
And here's Malcolm.
Happy anniversary.
And Neil.
How's everybody doing? Happy anniversary. Allison.
Well, I guess I want to wish you a happy 50th, and we are certainly proud and glad to be a part of it. And you see my three, how well behaved they are. They're all over the room and all over laps, and not happy in one lap. They're just jumping like little frogs. But I did want to say, Uncle Joe, that I had one message for you, and just want to do it on tape in case you ever want to watch it again, is my friend George, he wanted to send you a message, and he wanted to say, don't forget Election Day. And if you need to call him, his number is 733-7333. And he thinks a lot of you, and we'd like to keep giving you all those messages. And I think Gray has a message for Uncle. You want to say it? You want to say Doug?
Uncle Joe?
Uncle Joe?
Oh, okay.
Somebody got a shot.
We'll come later.
Jack? And then we're going to say, yo, Uncle Joe.
Hey, the cameraman's here. Take 195. Yeah. Just want to wish y'all a happy 50th anniversary.
All right. Say, hey, yo, Jack. Say, hey, yo. Say, hey, yo.
All right, we'd like to toast Peggy and Joe on their 50th anniversary. We look forward to being there for a more personal celebration.
Happy anniversary!
Happy anniversary!
Cheers!
Cheers! Take a glass, Malcolm.
Malcolm, you're busy drinking.
Slow down.
Cheers! Say cheers!
October 17th is a day of memories for many ways. Here I am at the NBC News Channel, and it was Jose Ferrer who starred in an NBC program called The Producer's Showcase. In fact, it was premiering in 1955, the same year that I was born. Ferrer also won an Oscar for his performance in the film version. On October 17th, 1962, the Beatles first appeared on Great Britain's Granada television network. And in 1967, the rock musical Hair opened at New York Shakespeare Festival Public Theater. Speaking of Hair, let's go back to Michigan and where the Sugar Popp family is standing by.
Happy anniversary, you and Peggy. 50th anniversary. Dolly and I enjoying ourselves up in Lake Antoine in Iron Mountain, having a great time, thinking of you right now. And what a beautiful family you've had. And you know what? You grew it up to us that we have beautiful families too. Thank you.
Hi, Joe and Peggy. Happy anniversary.
You've had 50 wonderful years, and I'm sure you're going to have 50 more. We wish we could be with you to help you celebrate, but this is our way of telling you happy anniversary.
Yeah.
Uncle Shug's son Tim and his family now join us from Peoria, Illinois.
Baby.
You want to kiss him?
Kiss him, baby.
Mm. Starting with a kiss. Okay. Hello, Aunt Peg, Uncle Joe.
Hi.
We just wanted to wish you a happy 50th anniversary. We want to make sure we got that right. 50, 50, not 15.
Yeah.
We're just coming up on 7 ourselves. So just thinking about 50 is just daunting. You remember Riley. Riley's almost 2 now. And Amy is holding Miranda, the newest addition. Newest addition to the Tim Popp family. She is just 2 weeks old. And we just wanted to wish you a happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary!
Wanna say bye-bye?
Say bye-bye, Riley.
Riley, say bye-bye.
Say
bye-bye.
Say
bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
More history on this day. In 1918, Yugoslavia proclaimed itself a republic. It was 1979 when Mother Teresa was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. October 17, 1983, actor Anthony Quinn opened on Broadway the revival of the 1968 musical Zorba. In 1989, an earthquake measuring 6.9 on the Richter scale rocked California. In fact, 58,000 fans were at Candlestick Park watching the third game of the World Series. As a consequence, that game was canceled. Well, staying with the sports theme, Nets now go down to Florida, where Coach Bud Carson and wife Linda are standing by.
Hey, congratulations, Joe. Congratulations, Peggy, on your 50th anniversary. I can't believe it's 50 years. Where did all that time go? I've known you for 40 years. Oh, Joe, you have such a great family. Done so many outstanding things. And Peggy ought to be so proud of the family that she spent more time raising than you did, Joe. We both know that. I don't know of a more outstanding family than Joey, Jim, and Karen. And all the places we've coached together, Joe, from Georgia Tech, Cleveland, back to Carolina. And what a friendship. I don't have a better friend than Joe Popp, even though we're not able to see each other. You know, your legs bother you and my lungs bother me, and we've just spent, one thing we can do is look back on a lot of great memories. I certainly do. I think of the first time I ever heard of Joe Popp, it was Jim Hickey talking about you just before your state championship game. Well, how he thought you were the most outstanding high school coach he'd ever known. Next year, you're at Carolina coaching. And that was the beginning of what I consider to be an outstanding friendship. So many things I wanted to say on this in a short period of time. Joe, I gotta check my notes here. The only bad thing I think that, well, let me delete that, that's not true. I think back to some of the things we've done together. Linda reminded me of a story that I always tell about you. When we were having a get-together before the 1971 season at Georgia Tech with the staff and the wives, and Coach Dodd, all of us, and we were having it at the country club. Golly, I can't even think of the country club, the real big, snobbish country club. And lo and behold, sitting not far away was Coach Bobby Dodd and his wife. I think he was there to make certain that our party was orderly. I had no idea that he was coming. We were very concerned about, once he came there, about keeping it very subdued. But before the night was over, Coach Dodd was introduced to a great singer, Moon River. Remember that Moon River show? Oh boy, Remember I said, Joe, no singing tonight. Coach Dodd's here. We got to keep everything very calm. Did you all of a sudden I heard that Moon River and you sang it like nobody else can sing it? And I looked up and Coach Dodd and his wife had a smile on their face. You loosened everything up that night like you normally did. And we went on to have one of the best parties I've been around. Well, after we, I've also got a picture here that you probably don't have. I'm going to get it made for you. If you don't have, let me know and I'll get it made for you. Get it sent up. Linda knows how to do that on the internet. But it's after the Sun Bowl pictures of all of us, including Jesse Outler and a lot of our good friends, Lamar Leachman, people like that. We had dinner after the game. I'm sure you remember that. Golly, just so many great times, so many great stories you were able to tell. You had a knack for doing that. You always had the great communication skills. So if I could have just borrowed some of those, I don't think we'd ever been fired at Cleveland or Georgia Tech. I'll never forget that when I did get fired at Georgia Tech, the guy who was with me right to the end was Joe Popp. I've never forgotten that, and I will always be indebted to you for that, for a lot of other things. You're an outstanding coach, an outstanding man, and had an outstanding family and an outstanding life, and I'm proud to be your friend. Congratulations.
Happy anniversary, Joe and Peggy. I cannot believe that you've been married 50 years. First time I remember you guys was when you were at Georgia Tech, and I guess when I first got to know Bud, I saw Joe as much as I saw Bud. And Joe, I can never remember you without a smile on your face. I can't believe that you're still not smiling all the time, because I never saw you when you weren't smiling, and you were always making everybody around you laugh. I remember Bud talking about you when you guys were coaching together at Georgia Tech, and he said that you were great at getting the players up, getting their spirits up, getting their morale up, and getting them ready for a football game, and all the players loved you, so he could always go to the players through you. And then I met Peggy, and I was really impressed with Peggy because she was the only other wife I knew that worked, that was also married to a football coach. So you proved to me, Peggy, that you could do it. And I was really amazed, because at that time I had one kid, and you were married to a coach, so you were at all the ball games and supporting him and keeping his spirits up, making sure you were there for him, and then you were always driving carpool for three kids. Jimmy was just a little tiny thing then, and Peggy and Karen and Joey were older, and you were driving carpool everywhere. I remember Karen was swimming at that time, and they were involved in everything. So, and you're also working at the drugstore, and I was so impressed by that. And you're always at the games and always making sure that you couldn't be down or unhappy or complain about things during football season, so you had to handle everything, and I was really amazed at that. I'll never forget when Bud was fired at Georgia Tech. Before he was fired, that same day he was just surrounded by the other coaches and all the people that wanted to be best friends with the head coach. And then after he was fired, there was a picture of he and Joe all alone walking away. And that's the way it was. Joe was the one person that stood beside him when he was fired. There were thousands of people during those wins and during Super Bowls and during bowl games. But when he was fired, it was only Joe. I'll never forget that, Joe. And I remember when we went to Pittsburgh. One thing I really remember is when you guys came up to a ball game in Pittsburgh, and we went to the mountain in Pittsburgh, the high thing in Pittsburgh, and we went to a church up there and prayed that they would win. I think we went to the Super Bowl that year, so I guess those prayers were answered. Then when we went to Cleveland, Joe, you were with us in the house. We moved into our new house. Remember that? We were all laughing, and it was really funny, and you helped us move in. You helped unload the furniture and set things up and get dinner that night, and we had such a great time. And Bud was so happy to have you there, because he said that you were so great for morale, and you could really get the players up. You could get them ready for a game like nobody else he had ever known, and you could always get everybody loosened up when people were getting angry and really getting to snarl at each other. You could really loosen them up. And Peggy was probably the only person I could really talk to. Peggy, I could always tell you anything, and I always knew that you would care and understand and have a good answer for it. And then when Joe had the stroke, Peggy, you were unbelievable when you came up there and stayed all that time in that one little place and made everything work out right. You helped Joe get back on his feet again, get back to himself again. Meanwhile, you still had Peggy's shoe store. So you proved you can be a very successful businesswoman and a great wife and a great mother. We think your family is the greatest family we know. You're our example of how you can be in football and still be a great family. We're so proud of you all. Remember when we came up there to visit you and we went to the Biltmore? Peggy, we still talk about that. Kathy and I had so much fun. And I remember when you moved to Mooresville and we came up to see your house. I'd never seen a house with a butler's button under the table. That was the biggest, most glamorous house I'd ever seen before. Still haven't seen one with a butler's button under the table. But we still consider you our very best friends in all the world. You know, it's funny, every Christmas Eve I think of your party and what a great time you're having, and I've never been to one of those Christmas parties, but every Christmas Eve I think of you and that party. We miss you guys so much, and we hope that you have a wonderful, wonderful time together.
Happy 50th anniversary, Joe.
He's a cameraman.
Hey, this is a pro here. I just carry the camera around.
Happy anniversary!
This date, your anniversary, is also the date for some notable birthdays, including John Paul I, playwright Arthur Miller, actors Rita Hayworth, Montgomery Clift, Tom Poston, Timothy Bottoms, Superman's Margot Kidder, and my three sons, Beverly Garland. Jupiter Hammond, in 1711, the first African-American to publish poetry. William Candy Cummings, born in 1848, and the creator of the curveball. In 1903, Irene Ryan, remember her? She was Granny on the Beverly Hillbillies. Other birthdays include George Wendt, you know him as Norm on the TV show Cheers, and Daredevil, Evel Knievel, CFL's Dave Cutler of the Edmonton Eskimos. Two notable deaths on this date. Singer Tennessee Ernie Ford in 1991, and just 3 years ago, my mother-in-law, Ann Walton. Well, even though some loved ones aren't with us during this special day, they are certainly here in spirit. So many others also wish you a happy 50th, such as Jack and Aline Day, Dr. Ken Carr, and your brother Alec and his family, Georgia, and son Richard. In Pennsylvania, other family members are ready to wish you a happy anniversary as well. Let's join them now.
We're all here at the lake. We're getting ready to do our video for Uncle Joe and Aunt Peg to wish them a happy 50th anniversary. Cliff and Carol are here visiting for the weekend.
Hey, Brother Joe. Hi, Peg.
Hi, Joe. Hi, Peg. Happy anniversary.
50 years old today.
Today. Get that way.
Hello.
Max, say hi.
Say happy anniversary.
No.
Jay. Happy anniversary, Jay.
Go ahead, you again, Uncle Cliff, has something to say.
No, I'm just going to say, but Brother Joe, I just want to wish you all the best. Many, many more years together. Carol and I, it's been 20 years for us this year, coming up in December. We continue to be as happy as we ever were, just as I'm sure that the two of you are, and we're all very blessed, and we love you very much, and hope to see you soon. Have a great day.
Hey, Brother Joe, happy anniversary, and Peg. You've raised three beautiful...